So things is all stiffened up probably and things isn't running smooth.
Notice the ratchet mechanism on the boom that goes in and out with a piston that is attached to a cog that is
Oh, yes, aye.
Yes.
What's our rack and pinion?
A rack and pinion.
Yeah.
So it's not a cable, it's a rack and pinion.
The only cable is hoisting it up, you see.
Aye. And so that's another piston, it's another cylinder and piston underneath that's doing pushing the rack up.
I think it's that one in the belly.
Aye, that's right, yes. And it's got some steam coming out of it.
That's what that man did. He's working to leave there because he was there's a man in there in the main controls and he's working that rack and pinion
there. Yes. So it's a three-man operation, a stoker.
Main man and the tip man.
But what were you saying when this was first put into the quarry in Lincolnshire? 1,000 men were made redundant. It took the place of 1,000 men. Wasn't that what he was saying before?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, you can imagine it does the work of an awful lot of people.
Lincoln, Ruston, Gossage place down, which they still should have been making machines. Same as NCK's, Ipswich, and Sheffield. Yeah, machines down there, factories all over. And then you see all the Japanese men came over and started fetching their machines in and stuff.
Aye.
Pushing out now, he's going to load now. Right. But once he swings back like that, and then digs the bucket in, and then he comes up, he'll be watching that block coming up the top of the jig, and he knows he can't get go any further than that, otherwise he'll break the ropes. And the same with the rack, the man is controlling the rack. He'd be watching how far it can come, but there is actually stops on there that it won't come anymore, so the piston would probably release a valve or something like that, you see, that the pressure isn't there all the time, or he'd let go of the lead.
I was wondering.
The man is sitting here in the centre, controlling, he'll know, he's watching that at the same time, and once it's to its limit, he'll let go of the pressure. Same when you are hoisting with these things, you know how far to go, but that when it's your bucket's full, there's no need to keep hoisting until it won't go any further. It's just a knack you have.
Is there a stop that if you were, I mean, you know, if you were a beginner or something, that...
Well, you'd fetch the ropes tight up to the block, up to the top, and you'd just cut the rope,
it would snap.
Bust the ropes if you kept going, but once it comes up to there, it sort of knocks your hand back, but you know you have to stop at that point. Now, see, he's lifting the bucket.
Oops.